Robbie just stayed in that at bat. I mean, he took that 2-2 pitch, spit on a really good pitch there. Just that's kind of what we've seen from him, huh? Professional at bat in that situation.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's as big of an at bat. We were down to our last strike, and he delivered a big blow. And it was quite a game. You know, the whole game could have gone either way, I think, for both teams. And then we got the final pitch and obviously put him away. So it was a big win.
Yeah, I mean, it was, you know, we came in talking about Cole, you know, and Casey kind of hung right there with him, even though, you know, his pitch count was up and I felt like he really had to battle, you know, he had to compete. Just can you kind of assess what you saw from him in those
No, he was impressive. Casey was impressive. I mean, he obviously the first inning took a little bit of a toll out of his pitch count, but he hung right in there. And, you know, to see what he did to the top of their order, you know, a bunch of punch outs and was able to pitch in and out of traffic with really good stuff. You know, there was only a couple pitches that we talked about after his outing that, you know, could go either way, either pitch selection or execution. You know, the one pitch to Odor, and he hits the ball out of the ballpark to the pull side. We've seen that before out of him. So, but he did a really good job of matching Cole in a game where going into it, you know, they may never have to face one another, but I think Casey's well aware that we're facing Garrett Cole and we're going to need to match 0 for 0.
You know, it doesn't matter as much now, but was that a cross up on the pass ball or did he just miss it?
I think he just missed it. I haven't talked to him about it. I mean, we stayed away from him after I hit for him. And then obviously the celebration at the end. So I haven't talked to him. I'll take a look at it, but it looked like the ball beat him to the spot. You know, you talk about as a catcher, you try to beat the ball to the spot whenever it's off. You know, offline or not in the strike zone, it looked like the ball beat him. So I'll look at it and we'll talk to Jake about it. But I know that empty feeling that Jake had, knowing, you know, that at least there was a chance that was going to be, you know, very costly. But fortunately, we picked him up.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Chris. Go to Cody Stavenhagen from The Athletic.
Hey, Jay, seems like you guys targeted Robbie pretty aggressively this offseason just to see him really become a stabilizing presence at the top of the order. What's it mean to this club?
It means a lot to us. You know, I think it's what he's doing on the field we get to see, and everybody gets to see. How he prepares is very impressive. How he's evolved as a player, it's very personal for me because I saw him as a young player and I've seen him mature and grow, and I'm very proud of him for being able to get to free agency, have a choice of where to play and choose us and reunite with him. So I, you know, for us at the top of the order, the professional at bat is it's as good as we've got and it's as good as you need. He can do a lot of things from both sides of the plate. He's very influential. I trust him a ton, and you know, he deserves moments like this.
Thank you.
Thanks, Cody. Good having Pedzold from the Free Press.
Yeah, AJ, you went to Kyle Funkhauser in a tie game. I mean, what does that say about, you know, what you think about him, you know, right now?
Yeah, before the series, we were talking in our advanced meeting, you know, the right-handed pitchers or relievers are going to have to step up against a really right-handed dominant lineup. They hit the ball out of the ballpark and, you know, we had to control their right-handed hitters the best we could. Casey did a lot of the heavy lifting and then Funk and Cisnero had, you know, came in and, you know, Soto's the opposite handed in the ninth inning, had to navigate some traffic of his own, but going to Funk and, you know, Joe's going to get the ball in that very next inning. Garcia needed to collect himself in the extra inning with the runner on second base. And, you know, we need a full bullpen and, you know, obviously the years have gone differently for different guys, but when you have a matchup like this, you know, guys, we're looking for guys to step up.
For sure. And then just, you know, for Soto's, you know, inning as well. I mean, you know, he seems like he kind of has that clutch factor in him where he can get out of it when he needs to. Just what is it like for you to watch that? And what do you think about his performance?
It's agonizing to watch it. I mean, we're all watching, we're all agonizing over the traffic and the, you know, but he's got the ability to escape because of stuff. I mean, the slider is real. The fastball is electric. He's not scared by any means. So I think he's got the makeup to handle anything we throw his way. But it can get a little agonizing when things are going on. And we need a perfect pitch against a guy who dominates left-handed pitching and Aaron Judge. I mean, I wouldn't wish that upon any manager. But we have the guy that can do it, and Soto stepped up.
Sure. And then just lastly for me, just Jamer too. We talked about him, you know, earlier today, but just the ability to chip away. I mean, how big is that when you look at the big picture of this game?
Yeah, 4 quality at bats and arguably should have been the hero of this game an inning earlier. He smoked that ball to first base. LeMahieu, I think, caught it behind him. It was hit so hard. So, you know, Jamber can do something. I thought he played good defense tonight, made some good plays, and really contributed to a good team win. You when you play close games like this, you know, you need guys to perform well, and Candy was one of the good ones tonight.
All right. Thank you, AJ.
Thanks, Evan. Go back to Chris.
Yeah, just the way you guys attacked and battled Gerrit Cole tonight. I mean, not a lot of damage against him, but you got him out of the game in the sixth. Is that a victory in itself? I mean, yeah, their bullpen's no slouch, I know, but right. Just to get him through six and out.
No, we're going to make him work. I thought we battled him great. You know, and again, you can, you know, the no damage or damage, like, you know, you're not necessarily always trying to do just damage against guys. You do have to peck away and take some base hits and take some singles. I thought we were aggressive with the stolen base, gave ourselves another opportunity to score. You know, he's one of the best, if not the best, in the big leagues. I mean, he's very difficult. And so when you battle him and make him work, and we laid off some pitches, got in some deep counts, you know, he won the last at bat a lot of innings just by having to work our guy to a full count, a couple punch outs here and there. But, you know, when you show up that day and you're facing somebody like Cole, go buckle your seatbelt and get going.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chris. We'll take one more for AJ. We'll go to Justin Rose from WXYZ.
AJ, team seems to just continue to battle and battle and battle, and they're getting, you know, obviously better results than you were earlier on in the season. What do you attribute that to? Just that battle or something else?
Well, no, I mean, I think our guys are settling in on what we do to have to be successful. I mean, it's, you know, there is preparation involved. There is a buy-in. There is some belief. I think all of it gets mixed up into a daily play. You know, we show up ready to play, and I'm proud of this team. I've told them, I've told you guys, you know, we're going to post and we're going to play our 27 outs. It's going to be our identity to where I'm not saying you're surprised or anybody else is surprised, but this is going to be our culture and our players are buying in. So credit to those guys for showing up daily and having a game plan on how we're going to be successful. Have we been successful enough? Not yet, but it is fun to experience, you know, the good times when we put it all together.